السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. मैं प्रेज बी टू अल्लाह द क्रिएटर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स एंड पीस एंड ब्लेसिंग्स बी अपॉन हिज प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद द हेड ऑफ ऑल मैसेंजर्स अपॉन हिज फैमिली एंड ऑल हिज कंपेनियंस. डियर ऑडियंस, टुडे आई विल स्पीक ऑन द इशू ऑफ वुमेन्स राइट्स that has been the most complicated issue in the human history. The civilizations of the world have adopted the two extreme positions in this matter. Rome and Greece had tested the two extremes throughout their history. The ancient Greece and present day Western world have equated them with man in every sphere of life. While the other country like ancient Persia went to other extreme, describing women as a blunder of nature and creature which ought to be ignored. The Christian Europe regarded women as the root cause of evil and gateway to Satan. In Hinduism, women were deprived of basic human rights. Even a widow had to burn herself with the dead body of her husband. Dear audience, the Islamic viewpoint regarding women is quite moderate. Unlike the other religions and civilizations of the world, it offers a divine solution to this matter. It directly addresses the nature and appeals to the heart of human beings. It adopts the middle path and takes into consideration the physical formation of the women and their due status in human society. According to Islam, women are equal partners to men in building a human society. They have their right, they have their own right, privileges and status. They play an important and equally significant role in the development of human civilization. They must be given education and training so that they can be efficiently perform their duties. They have the right to choose their spouse and enjoy their life. They inherit property from their father and husband. Dear audience, in religions other than Islam, women were deprived of their rights. She was humiliated and treated like animal, like an animal. She was exchanged like a sellable commodity. Similarly, in today's modern era, she is degraded after being brought to the street for enjoyment. But Islam denies both the extremes and gives them a balanced position which befits their biological characteristics. Today, the West shouts slogans of women emancipation and equality. As per the West, a woman is free to lie as she likes. Islam also gives her equality and liberty, but they differ from those of the West. Islam gives a woman equal justice, equal protection, equal honor and equal rights to life, but it does not believe in the equality of work field, because the field of their work is different from men. If the women driven out of their field and taken outside, the whole system will be reduced to chaos. It will harm the society, as they will not be able to produce a good person for the future of the society. Islam provides her full freedom in terms of speech, movement and relationship. The women all across the human history could not give the women their exact and suitable status. Some civilization granted them such a status that was less than they deserved, while some raised them to a position that was devastating and dangerous for the social structure. Islam is the only religion that adopted a moderate and balanced viewpoint about women. It provided them last peace, honor, and self-confidence. It directed their modesty and safeguarded their chastity. Finally, the women should themselves deliberate on the matter thoroughly. It is better for them not to fall prey, not women emancipation and equality. They are biologically, naturally, and historically different from men, producing a noble, intelligent, and talented child is in no way less important. The West has deprived them of their freedom and mental peace. It has made them a puppet in the hands of male society. They use women at every step of life and put extra burdens on them. May Allah give us right understanding of matters. Thank you so much. Assalamu alaikum.